Six, and welcome to your maths lesson for Tuesday the 12th of May 2020. Today is going to be about multiplying fractions by fractions, and you will need your pencil, your exercise book, and if you want to get them up, the templates from Seesaw, but they will be on here as well. So pause the video to get that equipment. So we've got our flashback revision starters. There will be two slides. Please pause the video on each one and have a go at the questions in your exercise book. Great work so far, Year 6. So the next slide will bring up the answers for the flashback. Please do as we do in class, and if you did make any mistakes, just see if you can go back and find out why. So we did lots of work on fractions last week, and we have done previously, and then yesterday we recapped multiplying fractions by integers, so by whole numbers. So today we're going to move on and we're going to be multiplying fractions by fractions. So you will remember from when we learned about multiplying fractions by fractions that using numbers it's quite simple and straightforward to do, because all you do is you multiply your numerator by your numerator and your denominator by your denominator. Now, if you're going to show this pictorially, the easiest way to do it is by using the bar model. So here, I'm just going to pull that so you can see it slightly better. I have got 1/2 multiplied by 1/5. And then what I've drawn out is this first fraction. So my 1/2 is across the top. So I've split that into two parts going that way, and then my second fraction, my 1/5, I've split the other side going into fifths, so we've got 5 going downwards, so 2 across the top, the 2/2, and 5 going down. Now what I can then do is my numerator multiplied by my numerator, which is 1 times 1, so I'm going to colour in 1 of the boxes. And then if I look at my denominators are 2 and 5. Well, 2 times 5 is 10, and that should mean that I have tenths. So let's just check the boxes. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So yes, absolutely, I have coloured in 1 out of 10, so 1/10. Okay, so I'm going to show you that with another fraction by a fraction. I'm going to try and show you drawing this out. I appreciate it's not the best for you, but I'm going to try and do my best to show you. So we've now got 2/3 multiplied by 3/5. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my first fraction, which is 2/3. Now, because it's out of 3, I'm going to split the top part into 3 different parts. So 1, 2 and 3, and I'm just going to draw that in. So there's a start. And then I'm going to look at my second fraction, which is 3/5. So that means it's out of fifths. So I'm going to do my fifths down the side. So there's 1 of them. And then 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, and 5. And I'm just going to finish that box off. My pen's just running out there. Get the other one. It's no better. There, so quite a rough drawing, but I'm using the best with the resources that I've got. I'm sure you are too as well. So I've got my two-thirds along the top, or my third, sorry, along the top, and my fifths along the side. So I'm now going to go back, I'm going to look at my numerators. Well, if I do 2 times 3, that is 6. So I'm going to shade 6 of these in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I'm just going to write that in as my numerator. And then if I've got my denominators, so 3 multiplied by 5, well, that gives me 15. That means it should have been out of 15. So I'm just going to check that. 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. Yes, it was. So my answer there is 6/15. And I've also proved that pictorially as well using the bar model. So you should now be able to have a go at number 1, 2 and 3. Great work so far, year 6. So what we're now going to do is have a look how you multiply fractions by fractions with just numbers. Now, as we know, that is very straightforward and simple. All you need to do is multiply your numerator by your numerator and then your denominator by your denominator. So here on my first one, I've got 2/5 multiplied by 3/4. So I'm going to multiply my numerators first. So 2 times 3 gives me 6. And my denominators 5 times 4 gives me 20. So my fraction there is 6/20. Now, for some of these, you may need to do the next step. For some of them, you may not do. But have a think about that fraction, 6/20. And think back to last week's learning. What could we do with that? What could we do with 6/20? Now, hopefully you've realised that we can simplify that. And the way we can simplify that is by using their common factor. And their common factor here is 2. So we can divide 20 by 2, which then gives us 10. And divide 6 by 2, which gives us 3. So the simplified version of 6/20 is 3/10. So as I said, there may be some where you need to do that step. There may be some where you don't need to do that at all. And we're also going to look where we're multiplying fractions, but this time it's not 2 fractions, it's 3. And we could do more, but we're going to start off with 3. So same concept applies. Multiply your numerators by your numerators and your denominators by your denominators. It doesn't matter what number you start with, but I would advise doing the way that's easiest for you. So for this, I've got 1 times 3 times 2. Well, I'm going to do 3 times 2, which I know is 6, and then multiply that by 1, which is obviously 6. And then I'm going to do my denominators. And what I'm going to do here is I'm going to do 2 times 5, which I know is 10, and then 10 times 10, which I know is 100. And there I've got my fraction, which is 6/100. Now have a think if there's anything I can do with that fraction. And hopefully again, you've realised you can simplify that and that the largest common factor here is 2 again. So we can half 6, which gives us 3, and half 100 as well, which gives us 50. So the simplified version would be 3/50. So what I'd like you to do now, year 6, is using those methods, is to have a go at question 4, 5, 6 and 7. So pause the video so you can do that. So the next bit of the lesson is looking at problem solving and applying the skills that you've learned. So here I have got to find out the area in meters squared. So I've got 2/6 of a meter and 3/5 of a meter as the width. So I'm going to do 2/6 multiplied by 3/5. So my numerator times by my numerator, 2 times 3, which is 6, and 6 times 5, which is 30. And I need to remember as well that that is meters squared. So can you now have a go, please, year 6, at number 8 and number 9? You have done a fantastic job today, Year 6. Well done. So the next slide is going to show your answers. So please do pause the video so that you can mark them. And obviously go back into the video if you need to correct any or you just need to go back over some concepts. Well done, Year 6. You've done super work. I really do look forward to seeing this on CSAR.